REO Speedwagon, Only a Summer Love. This is a CVT guitar lesson for Dave. And yeah, really cool song. I've heard it. It's just been years since I've heard this song. Tuning standard for this. Let's jump right in. Section 1A. It's on the clean. I have it on a distortion channel. I'm going to cut the gain by backing the volume on the guitar. It starts with 2D, 3B, and 3E. What you're going to do. And with that index, try to mute underneath string 5 there. Because we're going to be doing some ups and downs strumming. Down, up, mute, down. So I would just make sure there's no opens exposed so you can get the string mute. It's tough to do. And then up, down, up, 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 down, up, down, up. It would be... Okay, so... You'll lift up the index after the mute. So, right, so you have. Then keep these fingers down on 3rd fret E and B. Go 3A with your index bar the 2nd fret on the D and G. Might be tough to do as well, but great chord. Same strum, same idea. And you'll lift up the open G after the mute. So you want to get used to that strum firstly, but you can run through. So you hear the note changes in there. There's multiple guitars layered over each other, so I wanted to get you as much as I could of all of them. At 6 seconds in, section 1B, it's a G major using the F form. 3rd fret E and B, 4G and 5D. You'll go. This comes in at 6 seconds, so let me check something out. So you'll have. I would do upstrokes, up, up, mute, up, down, up chord. Up, mute, down. Up on the chord, again followed by a different chord. Actually, the different chord will come in, let me show you where. Right there. Then you'll see your second mute. That's where we're going to switch chords to a C major. 3E, 5 on the B, G, and D. Tough chord if you're not used to it. And a lot of people have different ways of playing this, but I can hear the notes in it, and I'm hearing that. You'll do basically the same concept as the first one. We'll go mute, which you can look at that as part of the last chord, and then your up would go up, up, so that way it's following the strum progression on the G chord. Mute up, and then chord down, up, down, up. Rest, up. And then that's it for that. So your chords are... You gotta get used to the strum. You can switch the pick direction or strum direction if you want, but make sure you alternate where I'm alternating. If you want to go... That's up to you. A little more distortion here now. Section 1C, 11 seconds in. This is what I introed with. 12th fret, D, G, and B. Just bar that. Go twice and slide. Technically, this is two guitars. I'm connecting them. 5-7 on the A, 5-D. I go down, up, down. It's quicker, but you can do downs if you want. but it seems to flow more with alternate picking. 7 slide to 9. Down up 9-7. And then 5. So you have all of it. And then you start it over. Start with the melody. 5-7-5. A-A-D. And then right back to the chord. But this is different on the end. 5-7-A, 5-7-D-A. And then 7-D, quick rest. And then a 5-D ring. So it sounds like this. With the chord. Line with the X, Dave, in the tabs, it's a rest. Or think of it as a chopped, you know, nothing. As opposed to, you don't want it ringing. Section 1D. Open 3-3, last four strings. This is a G major chord, just not probably how you normally play it. Down, rest, up, down, up, mute, chord. So it's, and then up, down, up, down, up, down, up. So I'm going to do the same thing over a C add 9. Just add your third finger to 3A, but do the same thing. 4 times, fourth time no star. Just means you're going to end it on on just strumming the C add 9. To do the mutes, I relieve pressure, flatten it so I can mute the D and G. So we have, I'm making it look easier than it is, but. All right, section 2A. Coming in at 41 seconds in. 3A, 5th fret, D, G, and B. It's a C major, barring with my third finger. To a D major with an A bass. 2-3-2, open, open. Strum, 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 strum. So we have G major, 3-2, open, open, 3-3. Down, up, down, down. That final down is a 4G. Because it's actually, I'm blending two guitars, but. You'll see. It'll make more sense right here. And then 4, slide 2, pull open. Pick, slide, pull. 7, pull 5 on the A. 7, slide 5 on the E. And then a 3E. So it's. I'm making that seem real easy, but I've got it memorized. Into C major. Okay, so you go from that to C to D, and it changes. 3-2 open, top three strings. Open 3-3, last three strings. And we're gonna go down up. And then 2 on the low E. Into an E minor. Open 2-2. Open, open, open. And then slide off the low E, 12th fret. Open A. And then again. And then 2-1, G and B hit together. Do that twice. C major. D major. C once, D major 4 times. Then you hit a bunch of repeats, probably back to, let me see. It might go back into that. It repeats all those sections though. Solo comes in at a minute 54. I think that finishes out the song. 15B slide. And he takes his pick and just tap, holds it sideways, hits the strings. Does that twice. It's like. I don't know if we did it on purpose, but it's there. 8B vibrato. 5 slide to 8. Use your middle finger. And that's on the B. And then 7E. 8B. 7G vibrato. So 3B, third finger, slide to 8. Back to 7E. Wait a minute. Yeah, it's basically repeating that. And then this time it'll go 7, 8, 7, E, B, G. Slide it. 2G, slide to 4. 3B. So you have 3rd finger, 3rd fret B, slide 5. And then 3E, 3B. 5E, bend release. And then 5, pull 3. 3, slide. Okay, we're going to mute the B and E. And then we're going to go 10th fret, high E, hammer 10. Sounds like this. So down, up, down. 10th fret barred, B and E, hammer 12 on the B, pull 10. And then mute, down, up, G and B. So it's 12D, hammer 14, down, up, mute, D and G. 12, hammer 14 on the G. 15E. 14G, bend, hold, 15E, pick 14G, release, pull off to 12. That's a lot of stuff, but that's what's happening. You're going. Pull 12. 14, 12, DG, vibrato. Top of page 4, 211 timestamp, mute the G and B, down up, followed by a 15B. Bend or pre-bend, so it's you'll go down, up, down, up, down, up, down, and then a bend with a pick. Okay, I'm gonna zoom a little since we're soloing here, up in the same kind of area. 12B, 14 pull, 12G, 14D, knuckle shift, go down to 14G, D. And G. So it's 12G, 14 D and G. And back to 14, 12 DG. Vibrato. So you have 217. We're going to go middle finger 12G, slide 16. 15B, 16G. 17 on the B to 15E, slide. 15B, middle finger, slide to 17. 15E and B, so. And then you'll go 17E, bend, release, pull 15. 17, pull 15. 17, bend. Pre-bend. Release, pull off to 15, 17, pull 15, and 19, pull 15. Back to 17, pull 15. 17, pull 15, hammer 17 on the B to 15E. So it's awesome. 17, pull 15 on the B. 16G. Slide 14, and then go 12G, and then go 14, DGD, 12G twice. Okay, then 15, pull 12B, 12G, 15B, bend vibrato. Bar that on the 12th fret. 226, pre-bend 15B, release, pull 12, and then pick 12. String mute G and B, and go right into the 15E, bend. 15-12 B or E and B. 14 pull 12 G. 14 D G D. 12 G bend release. So it's 14 pull 12 D, 12 hammer 14 D. 12 G, 14 D, G, D, 12 G twice. That's that part. So we have. Oops. Cool stuff. 15 pull 12 B. And then pick 12th fret twice. Do that two times. 12 G twice. And then 12 15 B, bend, release, bend, vibrato. 15 side 17. 15 E and B. 17 E, bend, hold, release, then bend, vibrato. Pre-bend, release, pull 15. 17 pull 15, 17 bend, vibrato. Again, 239 pre bend 17 pull 15, 15 slide. So some of these are repeating as you're noticing. 14 fret on the G, middle finger slide 16. We're going to pivot, go 15 B, 16 G. 17 pull 15 B. 16 slide 14 G, and then you'll recognize this from earlier. It's like 12.